be a fantasy. I can tell you got big, big energy. It ain't too many of them that can handle me, but I might let you try it out the Hennessy. Make them sing to this thing.
Wow. BJ, I was just blown away by that. Thank you so much. I met BJ 20 years ago on the first day of the writer's room of The Office, and I just thought, wow, that guy is so brilliant, so funny, and so unfriendly. I just need him to like me, and I turned out great. He's remained my closest friend throughout my entire career. He's seen all the ups and downs, and it just means the world to me that he's giving me this award today. That was an incredible speech, my God. I'm so lucky that my favorite writer is also my best friend. I love you. I'm so honored by this recognition. I'm so grateful to Stephanie Allen and Donald Wine, and to be associated with anything bearing the name of the great Norman Lear. Thank you to everyone in the PGA for this once-in-a-lifetime honor. I hate introspection, so writing this speech was horrible. But when I'm forced to look inward, I see that everything I do comes back to my parents. Like many of you here, I am the child of immigrants. And yes, and that unexpectedly became my secret weapon. My parents modeled a work ethic for me that later made the enormous challenge of launching a TV show seem doable. And they supported me when I told them I wanted to pursue a career in show business, which in the 1990s was a tough thing to get on board with. You know, the news was always telling us that Hollywood was trying to turn everyone into Murphy Brown, which now, looking back as a politically divisive single mother by choice, was maybe a valid concern. And I owe it to my parents, but also to luck. I won the lottery of mentors in Greg Daniels and Howard Klein, two executive producers of The Office. I was 25 when they hired me as a staff writer, and I eventually worked my way up to executive producer. I was the least experienced by far, and tragically also the most opinionated. The most important thing that Greg did for me was he let me write and edit and cover set when I had no idea what I was doing yet. Everyone here knows what a big deal and a risk that is, you know? It's not like they were getting anything out of it. I wasn't even one of their nieces or someone who could potentially become their second wives, you know? And they just took a chance on me anyway. And being around Greg and Howard was the first time I saw what it meant to be a good producer. And ultimately, that training is what gave me the skills to make my own shows based on my own experience as an Indian American woman growing up in the suburbs of Boston in the 90s. Not the Indian American experience, because as we all know, there isn't just one, but my experience, you know, the experience of a nerdy, overachieving Indian American girl with huge insecurities who grew up on romantic comedies and was desperate for someone to love her like that. They say that the more personal your writing is, the more universal it is. And I have certainly written what is personal to me, and I have been so lucky to be able to do that. And the fact that I am even able to create stories is a credit to groundbreaking icons like Mr. Norman Lear, who paved the way for all kinds of people to be centered on TV, nuanced, three-dimensional people who are sometimes awkward and selfish, but they're always hilarious and relatable. I'm so lucky to be able to work with brilliant collaborators like Justin Noble, Lang Fisher, Jessica Scott. I'm grateful, so grateful for my partners at Warner Brothers, David Zasloff, Channing Dungey, Clancy Collins-White, and so many others, Donna Langley and Peter Kramer at Universal, Casey Bloy, Sarah Aubrey, and Susanna Makos at HBO Max, my friend Bella Bajaria at Netflix. These are powerful people who have all believed in me, believed in the good business that is inclusive content, and encourage me to fill my productions with promising new talent, particularly women of color, It's so exciting to discover these artists, train them as actors and writers and directors, and watch them get poached by Marvel, never to be seen again. But seriously, helping give voice to this next generation of diverse talent is why my company exists, so that they can share their story, and so that the burden of representation doesn't fall on one person's shoulders. If my career has taught me one thing, it's that I can't tell all South Asian stories, nor do I want to. What I can do is take chances on other people, protect and encourage their voices, the way that Greg did with me all those years ago, so that they can tell stories that make us empathize and laugh, because really, that's what comedy is all about, right? 12 years ago, my mom got sick, and Greg let me leave the office writer's room for 3 months so that I could move home to Boston to be with her. And she was so weak from chemotherapy, and the absolute only thing that made her feel better was watching her favorite show, which was, of course, the Emmy Award-winning, beloved mockumentary sitcom, Modern Family. Not The Office, the show her daughter was literally on, but The Office's direct competition, Modern Family. And that's all she wanted to watch. So we burned through season after season, and during those little 22-minute stretches, she didn't have to think about how she was feeling or how much time she had left. She could just laugh. We could laugh together. And it was the first time, I think, I truly understood the power of what we do, to take people away from their pain and their struggles, if just for a moment, and enjoy it. It's such a gift. So this is for my mom and for anyone who could use a laugh. How lucky are we that we are able to give them one? Thank you to Howard Klein, to Kevin Huvane, Brian Lord, Maha Dakil, Michael Rosenfeld, PJ Shapiro, Katie Greenthal, Marie Ambrosino, Kate Lindenberg, and of course, BJ Novak. Have a great night, everyone. Thank you.